NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 77 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So, before we get this ready for release, in episode number 75, I did a kind of a testing scenario against the requirements we had for this epic in the issue, and a few of these passed. I tried doing some combinations of things to break stuff, and came up with three different things to work on. And so the next thing we're going to take a look at is the roll or total 3d20 with advantage should keep the number of dice minus one or one die if with advantage is specified. So we'll take a look at that. Pull it up in our console. Show what's broken. So, according to our, and I'll pull up the, let's close everything. According to our regular expression pattern here, you should be able to, the number of dice specified here should be optional. So I should be able to do roll 3d20 with advantage, and it should do something. So if we go to respond to missing, you can see that it should, if it matches it, if I try to do this pattern, so it responds to it, but if I actually try to roll, to call the method, it'll give us a no method error. Whereas if I do this, add with advantage two, which is what I want this to default to in this situation. So that's what we're solving for now, is the advantage-disadvantage situation where we're trying to, and it's actually the, that's the example of total. This is the example of roll. We'll do roll first, since total calls roll anyway. So similar to what I did so let me go in and fix these describe blocks to accurately indicate what we've got here. And then it'll also have that highest and lowest. So these are the eight spec files we'll wind up modifying. So do these since I'll just paste the block and then we'll see how many of these are applicable. Pause and then we'll talk through the modifications I made. All right, so I thought I was paused when I wasn't paused. So what I did was I took the highest section here, modified them so that the highest number isn't being provided there. So these are our tests to make sure that the items match as we expected to. So 48 highest is the equivalent to 48 highest 3. And so those are the kind of the main things that we handled. And then with advantage, I just kind of replaced highest with advantage. And that's total. Roll with advantage is the part that we add the new stuff to. So I'm going to do the same thing for lowest now. So I'll pause and take care of that. So one thing I did when I went through on lowest, and I'll go back into it for highest and with advantage, is that I went in and did the a comment on each of these to note what it's equivalent to. So I think that will help the reader of the code kind of know what we're doing there. So I'll pause and continue working on this to add this back into advantage and disadvantage, advantage and highest. So here are the comments on highest. Do the same thing on with advantage. So here are my comments on the with advantage version, and then I'll get lowest into with disadvantage. That gives what I would expect. So now I should have 28 failures. Is good. All right, and I'm gonna now make the changes to the total version of this. I'll pause and do highest, and then we'll talk through it. All right, so I've got the version of total here with highest, all the comments. So I didn't really need to change the equivalent role version there. Just noted that the just took out the integer there and added a comment noting that it was equivalent. I'll apply this to with advantage. Those are failing as expected. 6 failures. Far down on this. Highest. Highest N. Highest N. No, wait, it is highest, so. Unexpected arguments. So that is wrong there. All right, let's see here. Undefined method. All right, that gives me what I want there for highest. And with advantage, we'll have the same problem. But yeah, now we're just getting undefined method errors, which is what we want. So we're getting six failures on these, and with the rolls, getting 7 failures. So we'll have 28 and 24 will be the total once we get this taken care of. So we'll now adapt the lowest like I did before. Pause and do that. All right, so I've got the adaptations for lowest here. Let me make sure that that's total. It's gonna be the 6 failures. They're all undefined method failures. Do the final application to with disadvantage. Run those in isolation. Six failures, all undefined method. All right, so I think we can now, we run our, so we're getting 52 failures, 28 plus 24, as expected. So now let's go in to convenience methods and see if we can make these pass. So it's the D plus versions, the 4 of these we want to make D star. example here, number to keep is get number to keep from method name. That will now need number of dice as an argument. Similar to what we did with here, match data equals data, and then if we have match data, it will return match data to string, matching just the digits to string to integer. Or number of dice minus one. Let's see where that gets us. Most of the way home. So we have two failures, both in rolling lowest and with disadvantage. And those are just bugs in our spec. Roll lowest. Disadvantage. Rerun the suite. All passing. Run it a few more times. I'll pause and do that. All right, that's consistently passing. We'll see if we have any RuboCop violations. Line is too long. Line is too long. Repeated describe block. So I'll fix those. Let me do the autocorrect first. Let me close everything. To just the two with the repeated describe block, which I just need to fix. All right, we're still passing. RuboCop is specifically in roll lowest. Need to take the N off of that describe block. expenses. RSpec is happy. Let's see here. We've got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 specs, and the convenience methods. We modified each of our 4 when statements. We modified the method call in number to keep. And we modified the get number to keep method there. So let me take one more look at that item. I'm going to add a comment here. So I've got that change. We will add everything, write our commit message. So I've got my commit message, and the situation, I think I'm going to have to amend this commit. So I'll pause and sign it, and then we'll look at the edge case that I want to take care of. So I've got it signed, and the go to bin console. So one of the specific things we wanted to do is if 1D20 with advantage is specified, it should work, and I don't think it's going to. So happening here. One more time. Which shouldn't work anyway, because we've got, oh, that's the problem. So yeah, you can see that's a sneaky little bug there. So we've got 1D20 with advantage. It's not erroring out, but it is not including the lone die in the total. So I think I want to make sure at least on roll that that's accounted for. So I've got that example. I expect it will fail. Does. So let me propagate that to the other ones. So I've got that. There should be 4 failures now. And then on the total side, I'll adapt this. So the check here is if it's included, it will be greater than 0, which it will currently fail. So we've got 5 failures now. Expect it to be greater than 0. The right pattern. Still got 5 failures. Alright, so that's an error in my spec. So I'm making things too difficult for myself. It's just after looking it up, the greater than 0. Expecting greater than 0, got 0. So do the same thing with the other 3. In the correct file, ideally. There we go. You get the idea. I'll apply it to the other 2. So we've got our advantage, our disadvantage, and advantage. We should now have 8 failures. And then to solve this, so we know it's going to call the method that validates it in DiceSet. Where is my convenience methods module? There we go. So this is what we're, we can solve this by. Note, I'll add a comment here because this is so. So I've got my comment here that explains the kind of unusual situation for this and avoids if somebody in the future wants to work on this, the accidental introduction of a bug. So do that, it works. No frowny face from RuboCop. So git add do a commit, git commit amend, take a look at the log. What I want. We will push take a look at our diff. We changed all of the pluses to stars there, added number of dice, modified this method to account for the different situations, commented it, and then we added blocks for all of those situations in our specs. Put that in the wrong file. I'm gonna move that to the right file and push again. Force push. So amend and force push. So total dice. Highest. Total. Make sure I didn't make that mistake anywhere else. Doesn't look like it did. Total highest. Yeah, there it is. So move that out into highest N. Make sure in the same place I did. RuboCop is now working. Push. So the other build for it passed. We look at our code now. Still have the 69 commits, but the last one has been replaced there. Now the diff gives me what I want. Take a look at the action. It passed. Go to our backlog. Move this one to done. And we'll tackle the remaining one in our next episode.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.